Several types of floating leaved plants are commonly found in Missouri waters. Water lily, water shield, and American lotus are examples of floating leaved plants that can become a nuisance if not controlled. If more than 20% of the pond has aquatic plants, or if aquatic vegetation is interfering with some pond uses, mechanical, biological, or chemical control methods should be considered. Shading areas with large sheets of black plastic will kill virtually all aquatic plants under the sheet within 30 days. This method can be difficult, cumbersome, and requires daily monitoring. While pond dyes can darken the water, they generally are not as effective as other control methods. Some aquatic plants can be controlled by pulling, digging, cutting, and raking. Water shield and water lily can be kept in check by removing new growth at the base of the plants or pulling young plants by the root. Repeated cutting of the floating leaves of American lotus is also an effective control method. Cutting should begin before the first flower buds on the plants open in June. Be sure to remove the cut leaves from the pond before they decay and potentially cause an oxygen depletion and subsequent fish kill. Drawdowns for controlling nuisance aquatic plants should begin in November, exposing and drying sediments for a minimum of 2 to 4 weeks to prolonged freezing through early March. However, both freezing and drying may be difficult to achieve in the typically unpredictable weather of a Missouri winter. The grass carp is a plant-eating member of the minnow family and can be effective in controlling many submerged plants. However, they are not effective in controlling water lily, water shield, or American lotus. The waxy coating and thick stems of these plants make them difficult for a grass carp to eat. Adding grass carp to a pond suffering from too many of these plants could make matters worse. Proper identification of aquatic plants is critical prior to applying herbicide. Different aquatic plants require different herbicides for control, and some herbicides require additives to achieve effective plant control. A possible fish kill could result if too much of the target aquatic plant is treated at once. If these approaches do not work for your situation or to maintain long-term control, you might need to reduce nutrient inputs into your pond or lake. The final approach would be a total pond renovation. For more details about floating-leaved plant control, check out this free aqua guide available on our website.